And welcome back to Let's Play Star Trek 25th Anniversary Blind. I'm the RPG Chick. Gotta look for some berries. I don't suppose anything could be out here. Now, this is completely blind, just so you know, so... Since I don't know where stuff is, I generally...
A beautiful snow...
Don't know where stuff is.
Remnants of a recent...
Alright. Can we go in here? We can. Oh, what's in here?
An antiquated molecular synthesizer sits in the corner. Mr. Spock finds the scientific equipment in this room to be rather primitive. Dr. McCoy is glad that he is in a warm, heated room.
McCoy.
Captain Kirk wonders what is going to happen on this mission.
So do I, Captain Kirk.
Ensign Everts finds himself fascinated by the acolytes and their planet. A glass-fronted display of mineral specimens, including a meteorite, a few fossil shells, the skull of a cat-sized alien animal, and a very encrusted twist of metal. A multi-purpose workspace with fine, well-worn tools and equipment close at hand. An old-fashioned computer. It appears to have some type of simulation running.
I think it's a 486, to tell you the truth.
Assorted pieces of glass rest on this table, from ancient beakers to double burners.
Better than single, right? Can we do anything with this stuff?
The glass case is locked. You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
Okay, okay. Failing to obtain stuff.
Fascinating, Captain. It is an RDAC 4 molecular synthesizer. A museum piece in perfect working order.
Cool.
I read a collection of small items of no evident value. I would characterize this as a small museum display, Captain.
As would I.
Nothing to report, Captain. A vintage 80-12-86 of the mid-21st century. It is a fine museum piece.
80-12-86.
Residue of several different compounds are in the tubes. None of the compounds would explain the sightings.
Now this is nothing, or we just can't...
A multi-purpose workspace with fine, well-worn tools and equipment close at hand. A majestic view of Mount Idol can be seen through the skylight. This appears to be a study and lab. The equipment looks very ancient.
Okay, I don't think we can do anything with this stuff at this time, so let's leave. What is in the next screen, I wonder? Oh! How do I destroy them? Oh! Hold up. We pause when I'm in this menu, I believe. Kill. Well, that was easy.
You see a small explosion, and the Klingon's hand falls to the ground with a dull thud.
I guess they don't make Klingons like they used to, sir.
I thought the red shirt bought it for a second. So let's look at everything.
They look like Klingons.
I wonder why that would be, possibly.
Captain, we registered phaser fire and an unknown energy beam. Is everyone okay?
We're fine. Did you register any disruptor fire?
No, Captain. Why? Are there Klingons down there?
No, just an idea, Kirk out.
Fascinating. I begin to suspect that we have stumbled upon something that the colonists would never have uncovered.
What is it, Spock?
I wish to gather further data before making a definite conclusion, Captain.
So, she did not register disruptor fire. I'm not sure why he would think to ask that unless something's up. They're using different weapons, or they're not Klingons. I don't know.
James Kirk, filled with a premonition of more dangers yet to come. Your Vulcan science officer seems to be lost in thought, but remains alert. Ensign Everett seems to be rattled by the attack of the Klingons.
Yeah, he's a noob.
Dr. McCoy is still hoping the cold winds that whip around Mount Ida will soon die down.
Now, he got hit. Wait. I'm trying to see if he's alright. I can't look at him, like, I can't have him analyze him. Look.
Why would you want to do that? Let's not go misusing a medical kit, Jim.
Alright, I guess he's fine then. Look at stuff.
The path is surrounded by some beautiful shrubbery. Mount Idol rises above you. These are very beautiful Doctus cattails.
Doctus cattails?
A large patch of Kytellian tulips.
She got loud there. Oh, was that that hand?
It's the Klingon's detached hand.
Oh my. Analyze that, Mr. Spock.
This is a detached hand with some kind of circuitry in the palm, Captain.
Circuitry? Take it.
You take the Klingon's detached hand.
I sure do. Now if I hit I... There's a way to get to inventory, I don't know it. He's just taking out the hand, because that's all we have? Alright, I guess so.
Captain, I detect a recent avalanche approximately 6.2 kilometers away that occurred within the last 3 days. The mountain may be quite dangerous.
Demons, Klingons, avalanches. What's next? The Wicked Witch of the West?
That is not logical, Doctor.
It wasn't supposed to be logical, you green-blooded Vulcan. Why does everything have to be so damn logical?
Oh, I missed that. Can't I ever miss that?
We were caught flat-footed there. I don't want any more surprises to catch us off guard.
I literally haven't watched an episode of the original series in, like, sheesh, it's gotta be over 10 years.
I guess this isn't such a great planet after all.
We're ready to leave, huh, Ensign Everett?
Well, we've seen Klingons. Now all we need is a few Romulans.
Control your thoughts, Doctor. There is a high probability that something here is using our own memories against us.
Ooh. Very good, Spock.
You get no response.
I didn't want to talk to that.
Mount Idol rises above you.
What is this?
You see the mine entrance ahead.
All right, do we want that? Let's see if we find his berries here. Oh, we got the hand now, okay.
Nothing happens.
Use a dead Klingon, well, not really Klingon hand on Spock. Let's see.
Kytellian tulips are a perennial flower that survive in almost any climate. Doctus cattails are similar to their Terran namesake, except that they are known to cause hives if in contact with flesh for any amount of time.
I don't think that's a good choice.
The Brandzite pod is similar to Terran milkweed, except that the silk pods are in bright iridescent colors. Gindorian ferns are regarded as an intergalactic weed, Captain.
Mm-hmm.
Nothing to report, Captain.
So I don't know which of these things would be good. Hold on. Are these the same?
Nothing to report, Captain. The Brandzite pod is similar to Terran... The Brandzite pod... Doctus cattails are similar to their Terran names... Nothing to report, Captain. Nothing to report, Captain.
Alright, so let's try to take some of this stuff, I guess. I don't see anything that can be used medicinally. Unless it's so small on the screen I'll be pixel hunting, or it's underneath one of these Klingons. It's this one, I forget. The other hand.
You fail to obtain anything.
Fail to obtain anything.
You fail to obtain anything. You fail to obtain anything.
Alright, I guess nothing here. Do we go in the mine? Wait, what's here?
Various types of berries grow amongst the bushes.
Could be there.
Idle Mountain.
Mm-hmm.
Mine entrance. The mine entrance goes deep into Mount Idle. A Gendorian fern. Facadian moss grows on the cave wall. Spock, perhaps the most brilliant mind in Starfleet, pondering a most peculiar mystery. Ensign Everts keeping a sharp eye out for anything dangerous.
I love all this stuff, guys.
James T. Kirk, always wondering what the next surprise will be. Leonard McCoy, hoping that the cave will be warmer than outside.
The man seems obsessed. Alright, Spock. Feast your tricorder on this stuff, then.
These seem to be Laraxian berries, Captain. They have several medicinal uses, but Dr. McCoy would know more.
Oh, of course.
Jim, these are the berries we need to synthesize the hypodetoxin. We must get these to Brother Stephen quickly.
Okay. Well, it's not that quickly, because we've been taking our time here.
You have retrieved a sample of berries.
Okay. Let's go. We'll deal with the mine after. All right.
Jim, these need to be processed first.
I guess we have to go to that other area. In here. In here. Hello.
I never dreamed that Starfleet would be interested in my discoveries, Captain. But our guard often surprises us.
Are we going to use this equipment, or do we just give him the berries and he does the stuff?
The settings on the Ardak 4 have already been adjusted. Simply place the berry in the machine and the hypodetoxin will be synthesized.
Got it.
The machine synthesizes a quantity of hypodetoxin.
We've got to get this to Brother Chubb as quickly as possible, Jim.
Okay. Going as soon as possible. Fast as this game lets me, anyway. Not dead yet? Well, that's a good thing. Drink up, Brother Chubb. Glub, 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 chub, chub.
Thank you. You're most kind.
Now can I talk to you guys? I talk to you about what you've seen and what happened to you.
I headed up the party that sought to rescue Brother Kandri. Without warning, the demons appeared and attacked us as we approached the mine.
Can you tell us what they looked like?
Like the demons that have plagued devout folk since before our people left the Earth. Huge, muscular demons with ruddy skin. Truly the manifestation of evil. With bat wings, horns and talons and a pointed tail.
Oh my.
God preserve us all. One tore open my arm and I surely would have perished. But for my companions who bore me back down the mountain.
The demons didn't follow you?
No.
It seems to be some kind of illusion that's possibly generated inside this mine.
I am Brother Stephen, an Ignatiate following the holy teachings with mind and soul alike. I believe the anomalous mineral readings in combination with evidence of ancient disturbances in this otherwise highly stable geologic location indicates previous habitation of the region eons ago.
Why, Spock, you two should get along fine. He sounds just like you.
I would be equally honored to discuss medicine with you, Doctor, as science with your Vulcan associate. Let me continue. I believe our God made humans, aliens, and demons all. If I could get a real demon into my study, I would bless our God for the opportunity, as I thank him for everything in this life.
You tread close to unholy knowledge, Brother Stephen.
I appreciate your prayers, Brother Roberts. Captain, if you and your people go up the mountain, I hope afterward you will visit me in my study, which is next door. I'm too old to make the trek myself, but I'm eager for knowledge. In return, I will offer you what insights our God grants these old eyes.
Got a lot to say, doesn't he?
Just thinking to myself. Don't mind me.
The medical methods of these people seem primitive to me, Doctor.
By our standards, yes. Here the acolytes prefer a simpler lifestyle. Unfortunately, this is one of the consequences. You know, Jim, they can take a captain out of a starship and a science officer out of his lab, but you can never retire a doctor.
Not the good ones, that's for sure.
My mom wanted me to become a doctor. Honest. But I hated my biology classes.
So did I, but I became one anyway.
That is not logical, Doctor.
Neither were some of my professors.
My Uncle John lived with the acolytes a long time ago. He died in their service helping plague victims on New Ontario 6 20 years ago.
The acolytes did a lot of good work for the needy in this quadrant.
It will be good to help them for a change.
I wonder if we've seen these acolytes in the show. I know we've seen these guys.
I am Brother Grisnash. I went up the mountainside in solitary prayer, seeking to face my fears. Indeed, I found them. A bellowing Krognik demon with sharp teeth and a long snout descended upon me in a rush of wind.
Captain, a Krognik
must be all
demon has
then.
A decidedly wolfish appearance. Brother Grisnash, is this not the traditional shape of the Evil One and his minions among Tellarites?
It is.
I believe this may be significant, Captain.
I believe so as well.
I headed up the party that sought to rescue Brother Kandri. Without warning, the demons appeared and attacked us as we approached the mine.
Can you tell us what they looked like?
Like the demons that have plagued...
The demons didn't follow?
No.
You get no response.
All right, if we give this to anybody, if it would elicit a response.
What an interesting artifact. It appears to have been damaged. When you have a chance, take it to my lab and we'll see if it can be repaired.
Good idea.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Let me guess, nothing happens? How does he look now, Doctor?
This man has recently suffered a nasty but non-life-threatening wound. The damage has been adequately cared for. The man's vital effects are attributable to shock and stress.
Okay. I say let's go to this guy's lab. See what we can make out of the hand. I don't even know, can we go off this screen? Apparently not. Get in there.
Well, what happens next?
I wonder if any of this stuff might be useful.
This place looks real comfortable. A place to combine work, contemplation. Man's got an eye for the beauty of useful things, and for the use of beautiful things. I think we could get along fine.
That's highly illogical, Dr. McCoy.
This study represents a man with a keen mind, Captain. To judge by what I see, there is little which does not interest him. The equipment is antiquated, but practical.
Oh my, drinking and it went down the wrong way.
You get no response.
We can't talk to that.
I never dreamed that stuff.
Yeah, shut up. You wanted to take the hand?
What a fascinating piece of equipment. Highly advanced technology. You see here, it seems to have been damaged, however. Take it to my workbench and let's see if it can be repaired. I fear my hands are too shaky to perform such fine work, but perhaps one of you can do it.
Okay, yeah, I'm just falling apart over here. All right, let's put the hand on the workbench.
Mr. Spock, see what you can do about that hand.
It's pretty good animation.
This machinery is delicate, but I have managed to repair the circuitry.
Oh, goody. Now what?
This study represents a man with a keen mind.
Nothing happens.
See how the fingertips have micro-sized sensors? I wonder what use they may have.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Can you do anything else with it?
Nothing happens.
So we fixed this hand, but I have no idea what to do with it. I don't know if I can analyze the things in my inventory. Alright. I don't know what else to do. Let's go back in here really quick, otherwise we're going to the mine. Oh, this time the guy's staying in his little study.
Nothing happens. Nothing happens. Nothing happens.
Nothing happens.
Brother Kandre was, or is, my partner. I was on the communications link when the demons caused the rockfall and silenced him. He said he'd found a strange door with devilish writing. Truly, he came upon the gate of hell itself.
Truly, truly.
I am Brother Grisnash. I went up the mountainside in solitary prayer.
Captain, a Krognik demon has...
It is.
I believe this may be... I headed up the part of the...
Can you tell us what they looked like?
Like the demons that have plagued devout...
The demons didn't follow you?
No. I headed up the part
oh,
of the...
Oh, damn it. I clicked it again.
The demons didn't follow...
No.
No. Let us get out of here. Not sure what else to do, so let's go to the mine. Let me just save real quick.
Save new game.
Off to the mines with you boys. All the way. Get in there. That looked funny. Oh my. A little bit of dangerous music here.
A large metallic door is set in the structure.
Look at the blast to the side, aren't we?
A large pile of rubble blocks what appears to be a large metallic structure.
Can we look at this little thing?
A pulsing red light is set in the structure above the door.
Mm-hmm.
A cavern deep in Mount Idol.
Is there anywhere else to go, or is it just... I don't understand. The captain's disappeared. Is there a way to make these guys walk faster? I wonder if arrow keys will also guide them. Nope, it actually moves the crosshair. Okay.
James T. Kirk, captain of the Enterprise.
Yes, he is.
Dr. Leonard McCoy, glad that the cave provides some shelter from the breeze. A cavern deep in Mount Idol.
Know him.
Ensign Everett's wary of more ambushes. Commander Spock, curious about what lies ahead.
What do you guys have to say?
I recommend as thorough an analysis of this area as possible.
Sounds like a good idea.
No sign of demons, Klingons, or other hostiles, Captain. I promise, I'll let you know the instant something appears.
Don't be too anxious, Ensign. We may want to talk with them.
Jim, the next time you need medical help on a snowball...
Bones.
I'll probably end up coming along.
A gateway to an alien race. The wonders of the galaxy are endless, aren't they, Mr. Spock?
Indeed, Captain.
They can also be damn cold.
Well, space is cold. Now, I don't know if this happens. Got to show you guys the last episode. If it indeed kills him.
While you're at it, why don't you just violate the Prime Directive?
Got some funny responses.
I see no threat in the current vicinity, Captain.
Kill self.
Jim, you should relax a little more.
Funny how it won't even work against a red shirt.
Stop pointing that damn thing at me, Jim.
Firing at me will not gain anything for the mission. Captain, the consequences of such actions may be catastrophic.
Oh, it's only set on stun. Now, what's funny, what the ensign says. Hold on one second.
I thought dueling with phasers had been outlawed, sir. Sir, I don't believe we are in combat. Sir, the way you've been waving that around is making me very nervous. I thought dueling with phasers had been outlawed, sir. Please, do not aim your phaser at me, sir. Please, do not aim your phaser at me, sir.
Okay. Back out to here, thank you.
Sir, I don't believe we are in combat.
Alright, I'm done then.
That's a phaser, not a flashlight, Jim.
Jim, I see no need for using your phaser here. Is this a game you used to play with Finnegan at the Academy? Is this a game you used to...
Jim, I give up. Have you lost your mind, Jim? Jim, put that thing away. Jim, I give up.
I forget what it is that makes McCoy do his... I'm a doctor, not a something or other. Alright, let's go check out this door. Analyze, Mr. Spock. And obviously we're going to have to blast this rebel away with our phasers.
Captain, there are several weak points in the cave-in's structure. Careful use of our phasers from the top down should be able to clear it. Fascinating, Captain. This door is made of an unknown material. It is clearly built by an alien race we have no knowledge of. Fascinating. I'm registering low-intensity shielding unlike anything we've encountered before. That kept this door, and whatever is behind it, hidden from the ship's sensors and earlier tricorder readings.
Love the way it says sensors. Alright, let's blast this stuff. I don't think stun will work on rocks.
Assume firing positions.
Ooh, we're assuming firing positions.
There is no apparent effect.
Why not? There's somebody dead! Dead? Gotta be dead, not unconscious.
One of the acolytes who is trapped by the rockfall.
Ah. Talk to me, man! You've gotta be okay. Nope. I don't think we need McCoy to tell us, but...
This man is badly hurt and suffering from shock and exposure as well.
He's not dead? No, surprise the hell out of me. Medical kit.
It was a near thing, but he'll live.
Good, we don't need any berries for this guy. And now, Bones?
This man is badly hurt and suffering from shock and exposure as well.
Brother Kandry is barely conscious and is lying still trying to regain his strength.
Brother Kandry.
Oh, thank you, kind souls, for saving my life. Let me rest here for a little before returning to report this miracle to Prelate Angiven.
Just for the hell of it.
I think Dr. McCoy would be better suited to deal with this.
I think you're right.
Nothing happens.
Nothing happens. All right, I guess we're going through the door. Can we go through the door?
I recommend as thorough an analysis of this area as possible.
A gateway to an alien race. The wonders of the galaxy are...
Indeed, Captain.
They can also be damn cold.
How do I go through this door?
You fail to obtain anything.
Well, I don't know.
You fail to obtain anything.
We don't know how to open the door now, do we? Analyze this panel.
It appears to be a security lock designed to open the door when the correct handprint is registered.
Uh-huh.
The hand circuitry triggers a connection and the door opens.
Nice.
A long tunnel descends into the mountain. Commander Spock, curious about what lies ahead.
Anything else to say at this point?
I recommend as thorough an analysis.
I think we're all saying the same stuff. All right. Before we advance into here, let me just look at this.
This looks like some of the hand security panels on the Enterprise.
So let me guess. We still have the hand. Some games will actually subtract the hand from inventory even though that you didn't get rid of it, but it gets rid of it because it's served its purpose and the hand will no longer be there. Well, thanks for watching, everyone. See you in the next episode when we advance further into the mine. Endure, and enduring, live long and prosper.